Hi folks, in this video I'm going to show you some chromatic harmonica hacking. Just some quick fixes that you can do, which are quite easy, but will make a huge difference to the playability of your chromatic harmonica. Some aspects refer to more traditional chromatics like the Hohner 270 and the Herring 5148 series, or similar ones. And other parts will just relate to any chromatic harmonica at all. Okay, the first thing we'll look at is the mouthpiece slider assembly. This is a really critical part of any chromatic harmonica. Okay, I've got two chromatic harmonicas in front of me, a 10-hole and a 12-hole. Strictly speaking, they're not chromatic harmonicas. They're actually my slide diatonic that's made for me by Herring. But they work as, you know, they were designed as chromatic harmonicas. They work like chromatic harmonicas. So for the purposes of this video, we'll call them chromatic harmonicas. The 10-hole and the 12-hole work in exactly the same way. In terms of the mouthpiece, they've got a four-piece mouthpiece. Here's the slider, and it's very easy to disassemble. So basically, you just get your screwdriver, undo one screw at one end, undo a screw at the other end, and the whole thing comes apart. It's a four-piece slide assembly. There's your back plate, and you see it's got a sort of a slot at one end. That's so that it doesn't hit the little spring, which is what makes the slider go in and out. Then there's the slider itself, and that's got a little channel there to register in and out. And a little hole for the spring, and here's your U channel, which is a spacer for the slider, and finally the mouthpiece. And there's a couple of screws. This one's got a buffer on the end. In order to make this work a bit better, what I like to do is just get a bit of ordinary old Vaseline. You can also use chapstick and stuff like that, and just put a bit on your finger and just dab it on the base or one side of the back plate. It forms a gasket, so all these are just bare parts sort of lying against each other, and it's easy for air gaps to creep in. Okay, we'll just lay that down. Probably the first thing, one thing you want to just double check is that the cover plates haven't encroached over the front of the reed plates there. If they have, you need to move the cover plates back. This one looks all right. So I'm just putting that down on the comb with the slot there, making sure that it's at the spring end. Then the next thing to put some Vaseline on is the slider. Depending on what brand of harmonica you're using. Well, actually, first of all, I'm just going to look down the slider to see how straight it is. That looks pretty straight. If it's not straight, you can just very gently bend the slider, and but be careful not to put a permanent bend in it, otherwise it's very hard to come back from that. But this one looks pretty straight, and I'm just dabbing some Vaseline on both sides. Herring tend to veer on the side of having a fairly sloppy slider fitting. I mean, what it means is that the slider is not likely to jam, but it does mean also that there's quite a lot of potential for air loss around the side of the slider because it's not fitting in there super tight. So now we're going to put you can put quite a bit of Vaseline on a Herring slider. Also, the Hohner 270 can take quite a bit. Another one is the Hohner CX12. They all can use a hell of a lot of Vaseline, and it really helps a lot. Okay, just about to put the slider on. Now, which way round you do that is important. It should be, looking from top to bottom, it should be this way round. If I put it on this way round, then when I push the slider in, it's going to lower the note. We don't want that. We want it to raise the note. So basically, the slider should be put on in that configuration. And then the U channel can just go on. In this case, the screw and the little buffer are all in place, so I'm just going to now put some Vaseline on the base of the actual mouthpiece. So this is all, as I say, just to reduce air loss between these parts that just sit against each other. Keep plenty of kitchen towel handy to wipe off the excess Vaseline. Okay, so now I'm just going to carefully insert that screw with the buffer there, very loosely, and then screw at this end. And this is where you just got to be quite gentle. So locate the screw, put it in a few turns, jiggle the slider around a wee bit to make sure it's moving freely, and then put the put this one in. Now you don't want to screw these things all the way in at this point. You just want to just screw them in loosely. Now what's really important is that you sort of, with this kind of assemblies, that you use your hands to squeeze the U-channel and the base plate together, so that make sure that they're really mating. I mean, if the U-channel goes one way and the base plate goes the other, you can get slider jamming. If that happens to you, that's probably the reason for it. Just undo the two screws, pull it out, and then just squeeze together so that you get the U-channel and the base plate lined up. And then just tighten up a little bit more. Depending on what brand harmonica you've got, you can tighten up more or less. The herring you can tighten up quite tight because, as I say, the slider is quite loose in the channel. Now, it's still a little bit noisy. That's partly because herring use a very hard buffer. You can actually make your own buffers by cutting them out of softer sort of silicone tubing like that, and then you'll get less of a sound when you push the slider in. Basically the harmonica should play a lot more nicely now. The other thing to look for is the registration of the slider. Look down through the holes and make sure you've got nice crisp edges on the slider when it's in and out, so that you're not seeing bits of part of the slider poking through. If you do see that, you can actually move the base plate and the U-channel around with a screwdriver. You can push, for instance, the U-channel sort of half a millimeter that way, and the base plate similarly, and you can go around to the other end and you can move these things around a little bit. The main thing is that when you look down through into the harmonica, you're getting nice crisp slider partitions when you move the slider in and out. If you're seeing a bit of slider on the out position or the in position, then that means it's going to be a little bit leaky. I think I could move the U-channel a little bit this way. Anyway, that should be pretty good now. I'm just looking again at the U-channel sitting down nicely on the base plate, and it should be pretty good. Okay, now we're going to move on to the inside of the harmonica. We're going to remove the cover plates and look at those valves or wind savers. Now these are the bane of any chromatic harmonica player's life, but they don't have to cause you problems if you know how to deal with them. It's quite simple and easy to fix valve problems. Okay, in order to look at the valves, we need to remove the cover plates. And that's very easy. You've just got these screws at either end there. So again, just a screwdriver. This can't, if it's a Phillips head screw, you just use a Phillips screwdriver. In this case, with herring, it's slot-headed screws. So that only takes a few seconds. There's your cover plates. What I normally do is put the screws inside the in a cover plate and then move it to one side so they all stay together. Okay, now here we go. You see the reeds, so the little brown the brass things there, and then these things here, the white things, are called valves or wind savers. And the reason they're on chromatic harmonicas is because the mouthpiece is intrinsically less airtight than on a diatonic harmonica. So in order to save air, that's why they're called wind savers, valves are added so that when you blow a blow note, the air only goes through the blow reed and the valve closes over the draw reed slot. Vice versa, when you draw, I'll just try and demonstrate that so you can see. You can sort of see the valve closing and opening there. Okay, now valves are great when they work, but they can give problems, especially when in cold weather. You get condensation as your breath comes through the harmonica. It comes onto the outside of the reed plate here, condenses, and then the valve tends to stick with capillary attraction. And because these valves are meant to open when you do a blow note, because they stick initially, you get a tiny lag between when you play and when the valve opens and the note starts. So this is, it's just known as sticking valves. Pretty easy to fix. What you need is a nice little pair of scissors. I've actually modified these ones very slightly. I don't know if you can see that, but at one end, just there, I put a tiny little notch in the scissors. The whole principle about reducing valve problems is to reduce the size of the valve footprint on the reed plate. The less valve there is sitting on the reed plate, the less area there is for it to stick. So the first place you can reduce the valve footprint is just by trimming the end of the valve. So these particular scissors allow me to locate on the end of the slot, if I do it there, and then they don't go any further. But normal scissors, if I turn them around the other way, normal scissors will work as well. So you just need some nice little gentle little scissors. Trim a tiny bit off. You can go right to the edge of the reed slot beneath, and that will take a little bit of the valve off the end and reduce the footprint on the reed plate. Okay, so that's one thing you can do, but that's not doing a hell of a lot in this particular case. Now, herring have got quite wide valves. If you look at the size of the reed plate underneath there, you can see the reed slot is a lot narrower than the valve. Okay, so one way to reduce the footprint of the valve is to narrow it down at the end. So just come in from the end there like that. I mean, the valves are, you can be, just be careful with the valves, but they can take a little bit of bending here and forth. So you can see I've now trimmed a few of the valves, and but the valve is still fully covering the slot. If you don't want to use scissors, you can actually use a little ruler and a craft knife like that. That's another way to do it. It's a little bit more, a little bit slower and more cumbersome, but it can work just as well. So you just basically put the ruler down on the valve, and then get your little knife, and you can cut away a bit of the valve. So the main thing is just reducing that valve footprint on the reed plate. Okay, well, that covers the principle of reducing valve sticking. It's always, well, it's 90% of the time, it's these outside valves that'll give you the problems. And that's good, because they're easy to work on. There are valves right inside the harmonica, on every hole in this case, and they rarely give a problem, but if they do, you're going to have to take the entire reed plate off and do the same kind of thing. Well, chromatic and slider harmonicas in general are more complicated than diatonic harmonicas, and it's easy to kind of get confused about what's causing a problem. But I hope this little video of some quick fixes to common problems has helped you understand how easy it can be to work on your chromatic harmonica.